during these 2 years, time to time, I returned to this text, trying to interpret it more or less correctly. And now I want to share with you some results of this work. This manuscript defines Sachomo's unknown site of Tanglu in the general religious tradition as shamanism. It was a period in period long ago before Bon and Buddhism arrival, and should be coexisted with organized religious form. We can make not notion of shamanism among the Tanglu texts, but what are its typical traits, how can we define it as similar ancient religious tradition known in different world cultures? It's rather rhetoric questions. Putting aside all discussion about the nature of Tanglu shamanism, now we can do it referring to the written source describing important shamanistic ritual. This manuscript was defined in all inventories of our institute, our Asiatic Museum, as unknown Tanglu text, and during the current inventory work it attracted my attention because of its style, origin or essential meaning of Kamlanya ritual. In the English, word Kamlanya is generally translated simply as shamanistic ritual. It's true, but originally it derived from the Altaic radical Kam, which signifies ritual while shaman and trance communicate with the world of spirits with a specific purpose. It's quite unusual written source because of its style, meaning itself, and probable text complete version. In the context of great number of Tanglu texts in your rough collection, 90% of which are Tantric Buddhism texts, this one title of this source looks a little unordinary. This copy, according to the type of binding, type of paper, general condition and handwriting, could be dated to the beginning of the 13th century. And in the same time, it tells about ancient tradition that I guess initially existed as oral, and it was fixed later in the written forms. There are only one clear aspect of this text. My preliminary study of it during the last 2 years testifies that it's very difficult and doubt for correct understanding because of many reasons. And because of this, I can present here only glimpses of my understanding of general semantics. Shamanistic ritual, as the title says, is it really a shamanistic text, as the title defined it? Is it really in the general Tanglu source, not translation? If all answers are positive, what new traits of discovered source could be applied to characteristic of Tanglu shamanism? This last question is rhetoric again, in suits rather for prospect of further research. Getting a little ahead, I must say that for some reasons, my personal understanding of that Tanglu shamanism is concerned more with some organized pre-Buddhist religious form existed among Tanglu ancestors than to autochthonous pre-cultural religious beliefs similar to Siberian Altaic shamanism as this notion was firstly defined. So for example, when I made a Tanglu codex reference to special shamanistic structure or service in the Tanglu Emperor Code, I never associated it with shaman ritual in context of so-called pre-cultural autochthon concept, but rather with organized beliefs system. Now I should confess that the further study of this text didn't force me to change my opinion, but gave new, more wide landscape for research in this field. Anyway, let me first to use one more short shamanism definition. I am completely sure that we are aware of it, but anyway, taken occasionally from Per Kverne article Bon and Shamanism. So the existence of a religious expert who in state of trance, real simulated meditates between the and travel between the world of humans and the world of supernatural powers, the trance has the form of an ecstatic journey. Chief among the other characteristics is the existence of helping spirits. Another question for the discussion in context of this definition are presented by two opinions, by Iliade and Hulkrams, who studied the Lapland shamanism. So shamanism coexists with other forms of magic and religion, as Iliade thinks, and Shamanism has cultural and historic limitations not well adapted to the high level of social cultures, as Holcron states. After this short introduction, let me give the short interpretation of this text content, and please keep in mind that this is only a variant of my preliminary research, and then we can see how this concept and problems mentioned above could be applied to Tango text context. So it's introduction of text according to the definitely of the Tango characters. So the heaven divinity decided to punish Earth with dry. The chieftain or some ruler sent shaman to help. He performed ritual and all Earth's forces were destroyed. One of the astral spirits by the strong wind frost, the evil spirits go away. As for gratitude, people began regularly to perform the sacrifice to astral spirits, and in turn, the planet spirits defended the body of truth. Later, the ritual body was destroyed, and the spirits have gone away. The incomplete ritual is burnt without wind, and if one part of ritual is not true, the role is raised again. First, we find here a trace of some ancient cosmogonic myth. The supreme divinity of heaven decided to punish Earth and humankind for unknown reasons, and maybe there is no reason at all but only the will of this supreme force. Rothstein marked the motif of disaster or punishment that succeeded the period of prosperity in Dunhuang Tibetan Bon text and other legends of Tibetan Burman people. Another interesting point in this passage is the mention of some crucial important astral ritual performed initially by a clan ruler. And I can propose that later it was transformed to the important emperor ritual. I guess that the notion of this ritual we can find in Tangut Codex, in ceremony of Yuan Hao taking emperor's title, and also in some Tangut original text. The part of this ritual was lost, and this was first primordial sin for these people, and chief called to shaman for ritual kamlanya to perform it to save all beings. We met in first line wrote shaman here, but he looks rather as a priest performing sacral ritual or specialist on ritual, so like Shem or Bon in Tibetan tradition. So after this introduction, there is the body of text itself. Heaven heads appeared. Demon Bear kept the door closed. Another demon Bear enters house of all, looks around and steps to right path. White stars from the east enters to the temple. Demon Bear hides and looks, then spills salt. White stairs is not here. While Demon Bear is hiding, Heaven's head enters, sees the shadows of Demon Bear who blocks the way. We see here two oppositions. Heaven head, or maybe Heaven Bull, is a variant of its written incorrect. White stays and their antagonists, evil demons, Mbia and Me. Putting aside all these enigmatic divinities and their specific functions, we see here the conflict between demonic evil forces and heavenly good ones. The Heaven Divinity, or Heaven Head, defends some sacred territory, maybe Heaven Palace. They wanted to attack or to blaspheme White stays and split the soul, that interesting ritual moment connecting with soul. Please take attention that the word soul is in the name of the lake on the Xixia territory. Demon Mei is gone. Bear took arrow and facing the palace or temple hall and asked some question. Dark crocodile, mysterious figure, desecrated palace. Among all shamans, shaman all is the most skilled one. White stays amused with demon. Heaven had asked her about it. White stays lied to him and asked shaman over to hide her. White stays gave birth to a child, escaped accompanied by golden and wild wolves. Demon escaped and made evil to all beings. Heaven had hated demon, ordered shaman over to punish him. He tied him and threatened to mount a peak. Page 4. Heaven shaman is pleased. Earth copulated with white coal. Shaman Cloud saw it and talked to all about it. Heaven Shaman took blade, hit mountain head and killed it. Then Bird and Bear, Aten spirits, Yan Luan, Earth Lord reappeared. Heaven Lord and Earth Lord played dice on the Aroma Bridge. Poor spirit beat white drum. Shaman defended against demon with shinbone and blade. This is quite discontinuous, illogical narration, and we can try only to try to grasp general semantics through the illegible or discursive grammar construction. We read that white stays who had that intercourse with demon and child was born. Yet there is an important notion of different type of shaman, among which shaman's all is the best one. This notion of such shaman connected with certain totem animal is very important information for ethnic identification of religious tradition. We know that all, for example, as totem is widespread around the different world cultures. The nearest to this tradition is Tungus and Oirat people. But here the role of shaman is dubious and dual. He looks like trickster. He helped white stays, mysterious being, to escape under the defense of animistic personages, wolves, and then having God ordered shaman which called for spirit through he to kill the demon. He did it in ritualistic form, threat him to mount a peak. Please note that phonetically he resembled Tibetan divinity of places, Utha. Read about some copulation with this white call. We can propose that some mysterious mountain head or divinity took part in this creation. This copulation should be punished. In this point of tale, heaven shaman and cloud shaman are appeared. One of them, or the same one person, as hit mountain hit with blade. Then eight and evil spirits, Burton Bear, Yan Luwan or Erlik Khan, are appeared. And we must remember that mythic zoomorphic ancestor of Tangut is Korean Bear, and the sacral role of mountain in the mythology of Tibetan Burman people too. The state here is some act of creation as consequence of ritual. I guess we find a trace of local calendar agricultural myth in this episode. The core rituals and myths are widely met in Bon text and local myths too. Head is the metaphor of some divinity or local spirit. Another sacral moment, the play dies for land and kingdom ransom between the god of earth, Yan Luwan or Erlik Khan, and heaven on the heaven aroma bridge. We must underline that we find here the confirmation that initially Yan Luwan or Erlik Khan was god of earth, not underworld. The same we met among the ancient Mongol beliefs. Shaman Claude rolled the dice. Lord of heaven, Lord of earth, returned to their kingdoms. There is remedy from old age, equal to Mysterio 3. Bridge of aroma is destroyed. For these three, death Kamlani, old age ritual, and creation Kamlani, three mysterious spirits were summoned, and four lands were sent. Chieftains stole this world, and then shaman on the horse rode through the spheres. In the ancient time, Yan Luo put the death in the world, sent demon pay to get the dice, and nine demons walked after him. Song of Tchimei. Stop demon bear. He bent horse drum, climbed up the sky to hold the door shut. Demon bear was pushed. He jumped on the black sheep's back. Wife of Tchimei was transformed, and met by burn, and was punished for this body blasphemy. She was in kanga, kind of shackles, and was beaten with cane. The most interesting semantical aspect in this discursive text fragments are follows. The motif of dice playing is ritual for ransom for kingdom. The shaman plays the main role here. Because sometimes it was stolen by demon, which was sent by Yan Luwan to put the death in the world. Then appeared another antagonist of evil force, Tchimei or Tchimei Song. It's a very significant point, because this name was made in Sea of Meaning established by the saints. So there is some geology of text. Yet this is only firm evidence that this text is indigenous and good source. He may stop demon. He bent shamanistic drum, made the shamanistic ritual trip and stopped demon. But there is another aspect. Wife of Tchimei, who transformed in magpie, and was punished for this violation of body. Also read about mysterious three ones. Maybe it's mysterious spirits and three main rituals. Two of them are named Eskamlania for death and for conception. Kichanov mentioned the enigmatic three and Nasi people ancestral legends. Magpie teared out the tongue of demon, Chivei, destroyed the evil for 1,000 years. Yan Luo once sent beer again. One day heaven called for Tchimei and gave him horse drum to beat. Having sent him to God for spheres from death, beginning of the way has no chief. Chief himself findeth. It said in Ancestor script about Kanlania, who knows how to speak can kill with words of lie, who can walk clears the way to shut the hell gate. This aphorism is interesting. This aphoristic speech is quite clear if to compare it with other this text context. There is end of this text part. Another part of manuscript from page 8 to 13 is other texts having close semantic connection with Kanlania text, and it covers ancient level of Talmud ancestors belief too. It's a very interesting and very difficult for understanding mixture of folk tales of calendar agrarian and astral myths, and maybe also trace of real historic events. Especially interesting is the notion of some war where the Tibetans, perhaps, as may be supposed, were enemy who attacked Tanguls. As enemies, they are identified with some demon who destroys the sacred tripod in the West, and the West is called as dirty place. Analyzing all this connotation, we could propose here that here we find the trace of conflicts and war between Tanguls and Uyghurs, their Western neighbors. And at the same time, we must remember another sacral significance of the West in Tangut mythology. We also met here the notion of some mysterious nine ways or nine text incarnation. This nine number is symbolic trace of Bon cosmogony and frequently met in Bon text. We must mention here nine ways of Bon text, which were very carefully studied by Snell group. We also find the trace of local autochthon cosmogonic myths here. The god of heaven fought against the evil, built the temple. We met here such zoomorphic personages as cranes, Siwa, Liu, Bull Tarier or Tamier that fight against demon. Woman plays key and dubious role in this opposition. Demon cursed her as a main antagonist, and there is an animistic myth reminiscent inserted in this text. Sorry, I forget to list this text fragment, excuse me. So finally, turning to Kamlania origin text and range of questions with put in the beginning of this presentation, we can make the following intermediate resume. This text looks like true shamanistic ritual description with all archetypical traits and attributes. Shaman magic trip is a crucial one, ascending to heaven, to underworld, body transformation. In ritual action with shaman drum and shaman zumufi helpers. We must underline that this is a real magic trip, not a state of trance. We also find different types of shamans here. So we could assume that shamanism and organized religious belief coexisted in Tangut state in different social groups. As example, Mongol beliefs in epoch of Genghis Khan, while shamanism and Tengrism coexisted. But at the same time, I doubt that in official documents like Tangut Codex, there are references to pre-cultural autochthonal shamanism. I think it could refer to kind of emperor shamanism as it existed in Manju tradition, or rather to specialist on specific form ritual of religion without name, follow the Rothstein definition. And now I think we deal with cultural social limitation, but in the same historic and cultural context. So shamanism can coexist with other religious forms, but shamanism occupies its own separate level which doesn't correspond with complex social structure. What cultural tradition this ritual could belong to, Tangut or other ethnicity? Text refers that shaman O is the main shaman. Is this totemic evidence identity applied to Tanguts? I already have marked that initially this text has been existed in oral tradition, and it was fixed in writing later, and possible additions and interpolations were made in process of further rewriting. There is no any direct Buddhist implements in text, only some words that could be interpreted as a variant as dharma or karma. The language grammar characteristic argument for this is a Tangut original text, not translation. We find here another more firm evidence, the name of mythical hero Himei or Himei-san, that are mentioned in an indigenous soul seal of writing established by the saints. In the same time, We find here more wide semantic field, but not only shamanistic ritual itself, description. This thematic field includes elements of cosmogonic ancestral myths, folk, local legends, so the structure is more complex. All this incorporation to the ritual text on the rhetoric, to the ritual text on the rhetoric question. The same picture we find among texts studied by Rolf Steiner and Marcel Laloux. So we can conclude that for this ancient ethnicity, ritual existed as a fusion of many different components, but not a separate single rite. Or maybe in such case it's not shamanism in its strict sense, but complex belief system, religion without name. Excuse me. And finally, what part of ritual was lost and its sacral unity was destroyed? I don't know, it's a mystery for me still, but maybe it's sacred dice for gain that was stolen by demons. Anyway, we can propose that because of this tragic loss, death was created, a demonic force entering the world. Shaman made his magical travel only to lock the gate of underworld, but it was impossible to restore the whole order sustained by ritual. This is only my version of understanding. Thank you.